Justin McKenzie argued something today and said that, he argued something in saying that you, Judge Hlophe, today you are against the law. Today you are saying this. Kanti Ndlozi is prepared. So the attack to Judge Hlophe was basically met right there and there with a beautiful answer. So we then saw Lokhu Ndlozi defending Judge Hlophe. Very nice and beautifully so, defended the man beautifully so. So in this video, we've got two videos, right? In fact, I said four. Now that I'm thinking of it. Okay, bye, guys. It's two videos, guys. Two videos, guys. So we've got two videos. We've got one where, okay, Clayton McKenzie was speaking about the fact that today you are against the law, but you sentenced some of my friends, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? In other words, you are saying when you are a hypocrite. Look, Clayton McKenzie said all of those things here.
I want to say to Honorable Judge Hlophe, I'm sitting there and I'm shocked because you, Honorable Judge, have sent many of my old friends to jail with Roman Dutch law, which you enjoyed. While you were getting you talked about the blue lights. While you were getting the perks of the judge, being a judge, you never saw something wrong with blue light. You never saw something wrong with Roman Dutch law. Today, when you're no longer there, now you are seeing something wrong with Roman Dutch law. It cannot be. I'm going to pay for an appeal for everybody that has been sentenced by you, because you sentenced them with the wrong law according to you. Thank you very much, Honorable.
But the response is coming from Ndlozi. Hey, you're going to like the response. You're going to like the response when Ndlozi defends, when Ndlozi was defending, Judge Hlophe. Now, I don't know if you are noticing this. Do you see the causiness, the cause relationship here, MK partner, EFF, right? You can see it in Parliament. It's just vividly, it's clear. You can see, man, that, okay, you know what? These two political parties, they have an understanding of each other prior. They have an understanding of each other even prior to Parliament. So it's like they sat down and they understood, like they've studied in Parliament and whatever they're executing right now, it's basically who they are, and it's basically how they would have loved to attack this whole subject of Parliament. Because you can tell, man, Guti, you remember yesterday we saw Judge Hlophe in a press conference, a media press briefing, where he defended Julius Sello Malema publicly, so, and he was not ashamed. Right, he was very straight on the matter that I am defending him. If you want to attack him and if you want to ask questions, it's fine, you can do it, but not in this press conference, right? I have a duty, I'm duty bound to defend him, and I'm going to do so right now. So you can, like, guys, I'm not sure if you are seeing what I'm seeing, but I'm seeing this relationship between EFF and the EMK party. It's something else, man. It's something else, Parliament. I'm sure they can feel it. And even when they do their things, man. Yeah. It's like, that's why I said to you guys, today we're going to be, like, I'm sorry, I said this year we're going to be studying Politics 101, but we will also be studying YouTube 101 if we can only do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys,
There is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Before I can give you the video, Gandlonzi, before I can give you that video, which is quite interesting, by the way, very, very, very interesting. Before I can do so, I want to remind you that I did say this year we are going to see, we are going to be schooled in politics. This year we're going to see Politics 101. It is starting to give the vibes that I told you when I say this year you're going to see Politics 101. You're going to be schooled in politics this year. Hence, I took the journey to say I'm going to be capturing the moments. I'm going to be studying politics. You know what I'm saying? There are things, I don't like politics in general, but there are things that you just like in how they strategize and how they come about solutions of everything. But before we can proceed and talking about solutions and problems and this and this, well, the response, Gandlonzi, is this one.
There needs not be a speaker on the floor for me to raise an order. I hope we can agree on that. So I'd like...
You can proceed.
Thank you very much. The judge has written a thesis when he was on the bench, attacking Roman Dutch law.
Honorable Ndlozi,
your illiteracy is not going to help us.
Can you please sit down?
This judge has written papers against Roman
Honorable
Dutch law when he was on the bench.
Can you take the art?
You come here and you lie. You lie. This judge spoke about decolonization of the law from the bench. Don't lie, yeah, man. Must read extensive, well-researched papers that are peer-reviewed. Yes, yes. And he didn't say anything about sports, about arts. He gets there.
Honorable,
can you please take the mic
from Honorable Ndlozi?
There needs not be a speaker on the floor for me to raise an order. I hope we can agree on that. So I'd like...
You can proceed.
Thank you very much. The judge has written a thesis when he was on the bench, attacking Roman Dutch law.
Honorable Ndlozi,
your illiteracy is not going to help us.
Can you please sit down?
This judge
Honorable
has
Ndlozi.
Written papers against Roman
Honorable
Dutch law
Ndlozi.
When he was on
down.
The bench.
Can you take the
You come here Honorable and you lie. You lie. This judge spoke about decolonization of the law from the bench. Don't lie, yeah, man. Must
Honorable
read
Ndlozi.
Extensive, well-researched papers that are peer-reviewed. Yes, yes. And he didn't say anything about sports, about arts. He gets there.
Honorable
Ndlozi. But what's going to happen about the arts?
Okay.
I get it that now you get it. So because now you get it, Nami, I get it. Because now you understand, Nami, now I understand. You know, guys, I don't know where have I developed the tendency of not looking straight into the camera, but looking sideways. I don't know, because I know that I should be looking straight into this camera. But I still feel in lap of very best in a collab. So what I'm trying to say here, guys, is that there's that coziness and there's that thing that we are to learn. So far as politics are concerned in this country, we are to learn something about the issue about Ndlozi and EFF and how they attack points together. Also, what I will also like to point it out is the fact that Ugeitan Mckenzie had an opportunity of saying anything about his department, had an opportunity of telling us about the department and how he wants to help the department and how he wants to improve the department and what are the plans. For instance, Mantashi he got there and he said a bit of the things that they want to achieve. DA got there and they said a bit of the things that they want to achieve, right? But you listening to Gayton McKenzie, and please tell me what he said about the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture. I want to know. Maybe you heard it. Please tell me what he said. For me, it's like Gayton McKenzie prepared a speech to either go and defend the GNU or go and defend the Ramaphosa. I don't know, man. Or go and attack. He saw a speech to go and attack somebody. I was listening to McKenzie. I don't know. McKenzie. You are a minister of sports and sports, arts and culture. The least we expect from you is just knowing exactly what's the plan. That's the least. Remember that you are the one also, on the other hand, that is busy exposing people who are not working. You are busy exposing corruption. We get it. We don't fight you. We get it. Now you are given a stage in parliament to just give us a glimpse of the future of sports, arts and culture. You just decide to play play politics, and you know what I'm saying? You just have fun in the arena. Get it? It's nice to have fun, but at least tell us where you're going. Listen to Malema. He gets there. He starts telling us about what they want to do. You listen to Hlophe, or Judge Hlophe. He gets there. He starts telling us what they want to do as MK Party. So why are you not doing the same thing? Then if you want to play, you can then play, but having delivered exactly what you were here for, because you are not in parliament to play politics, at least as according to people. You are not in parliament to play politics, but you are in parliament to represent the people that sent you to parliament. I'm not sure if you guys understand what I'm saying, but I do hope that you do understand what I'm saying, that he did not deliver. Right now, based on what he said, I don't know, Uguti, am I confident at what he would like to deliver for us or not? I'm not sure if I can be confident on those things. Maybe you can, but if you do, then get onto the comment section below. Tell me what you think about all and everything that McKenzie has been saying there. But for me, she was like, McKenzie. I was like, hey, McKenzie. Go on, McKenzie. Do not play with this opportunity.